you're gonna go to the holding cell.
I feel that there are some people who, by the enormity of their crime, forfeit the right to live. He is such an evil person who had done so much harm, hurt so many good people. He is just a piece of garbage in the shape of a human being.
When Ted went back to death row,
there was no guilt, no remorse.
I don't feel guilty. I feel less guilty now than I felt at any time in my whole life about anything I've ever done. And it's not that I forgot something or it's closed off part of my mind or compartmentalized. I believe I understand everything that I've done.
There's pride in what he did. Death row is a terrible place. So Ted would get drunk and smoke dope.
There are a lot of guys heavy in the drugs on death row. I smoked a lot of weed, and I have never in my life been so fucked up. I don't like this dope that just gets you mildly giddy. I mean, when I smoke dope, I like to hallucinate a little bit.
Many days he was really, really high. His wife, Carol, would take drugs into Ted vaginally, and then he would take the drugs back to his cell rectally.
I'm gonna bring some dope down here sometime. We'll just smoke it. And Valiums and alcohol.
Ted and Carol were the French expression folie à deux. They were crazy together. Carol loved him. She told him that she wanted a child. And somehow they had sex in the prison.
We kept looking out the window. There's a black car. It was real nice. After the first day, they didn't care. Walked in a couple of times.
And they built this little family on death row. Ted and Carol and little Rosa.
This convicted killer, who fathered a daughter, tried to have a semblance of family life with daughter, stepson, and wife.
The narcissist in him adored the attention.